10 years since the village of Bukovlje first received a visit from the genealogists Robert and Sue Jerin. During these years, Robert and Sue have been bringing parties of American guests on genealogical tours to see the country that many have a close family connection with, to research in the state archives, and even discover forgotten family members and lost villages. Bukovlje is a humble village on the right flank of the river Mrežnica, and it came to Robert's attention, thanks to a woman called Peggy Jasina, about whom I'd made a film detailing her search for her Croatian roots, and how her family history is inextricably tied to Bukovlje.
One night at home, everyone was busy doing something else, and I had a little pity party all for myself. And I said, okay, I will do some more genealogy work, and I typed Domšić into the computer. I meant to type it into the Google search engine, but I typed it into YouTube. And to my surprise, a series of lovely films came up with the tag underneath Domšić and a village named Bukovlje. And I thought, okay, I'll watch. And I watched, I don't know which one I watched first, but I came to this film, The Village of the Dead, which is filmed in the cemetery. And I became more and more excited as I watched it, and I must have watched it for hours. And I ran and I got the family tree, and I would pause the video, the film, at one headstone, and I copied down all the information, and then I compared it, searching through the family tree, and back and forth and back and forth. I was so excited. I said, this might be the family. And I called my mother and I said, Mother, I found them, I found them. And we talked a bit, and I said, you can't imagine how excited I am. And she said, please don't stay up all night. Which I did, almost, until 3 o'clock in the morning, because I was so excited. And then the next day, a few days later, was when I messaged Andrew. And I said, I think you're filming my family. And then we began a correspondence back and forth. It's been an amazing thing, and I decided pretty shortly thereafter that I needed to come and see them, because life is short and you never know what can happen, and I wanted to see them.
Back in 2011, I received this email from Robert, asking about the possibility of them coming to the village for a visit with his tour. I talked with the ladies of Bukovica, the women's stitching group, and the idea was embraced with great enthusiasm. This was an opportunity to show Bukovlje, but none of us here could have had any idea of the impact that such a visit would have on our guests. What are your impressions of the village here?
My impression is absolutely wonderful. I'm back home to my roots.
But more of that later. In earnest, the whole village came together to prepare and make the occasion unforgettable. For several weeks, the village, and particularly the women of the cultural group Bukovica, have been preparing themselves to host a party of guests from America. The women are making a keepsake for each guest, a little bag filled with lavender grown in the nearby fields. Here is an opportunity to share with the outside world something of the culture and village way of life in Bukovlje that their forefathers would probably be familiar with. The ladies of Bukovica are members of a cooperative known in Croatia as an udruga. They meet regularly throughout the year to stitch patterns and designs onto cloth, many of which have been drawn from the surrounding fields. The ladies even tried their hand at weaving, having gone on a course to learn the skills of their grandmothers. Thanks to a donation from Robert and his tour guests, we were able to purchase a loom for ourselves.
You know, I said about celebrating our culture and honoring our ancestors, and the group has been very generous with the donation for the Zenska Udrukvica, which is the ladies' cultural club. And again, their goal is to buy a loom to make the cloth, the traditional cloth. So I'd like this to present this to the group on behalf of you.
But I'm getting ahead of myself. When the day arrived, the men got up early to prepare a special meal.
On the day itself, the men of the village, having previously hunted, prepared and marinated the meat, rise early to cook a special hunter's goulash for the guests and for the village as a whole.
At the appointed hour, the local ethnic band Kud Izvor played while the village greeted our guests with homemade cake and home-distilled plum brandy.
Now their grandchildren and great-grandchildren are returning. They are following a trail back in time that will lead them to a part of the country that they can call home. This sense of home arouses powerful emotions that seem impossible to articulate in words. There are forces at work that compel the individual to travel great distances in pursuit of any clue that might bring them a step closer to finding the source of their origins. A journey, the searching for and the prospect of finding family members in their ancestral village, is highly intoxicating. And the making of a connection with the earth where once their families were rooted can have a profound effect on the individual.
Hello everybody. It gives me great pleasure to extend to you all a very warm welcome on behalf of the Women's Organization Bukovlje and to say how grateful we are to Mr. Robert for choosing our little village to host his group. I'd also like to welcome our special guests from America as well as the members of the Kud Izvor, the firemen of DVD Bukovlje, the hunters of Lovačko društvo Brezetinac, and the villagers.
I remember Robert saying to me once when people were looking at the tour schedule, they could see that they were going to such famous cities as Dubrovnik and Split. But when they saw that there was a visit planned to visit Bukovlje, a lot of them asked, why are we going to Bukovlje? What is there for us? Well, I'll let our guests explain why.
What is your impressions of the village here?
My impression is absolutely wonderful. I'm back home to my roots. I do indeed. Mm-hmm. The first time we came to Croatia with my mother, when we came home, I could not explain to my husband the feeling that I had when we got to the property that was my father's homeland. Mm-hmm.
Emotional, but I belong here, you know. It's something that's part of me, you know.
So what does it mean for you to come to a village like this?
Just a wonderful experience. Just unbelievable. Very emotional.
Do you imagine it's like the villages of your ancestors?
That's what I think of it as. Just unbelievable. I never thought I'd have the opportunity.
Yes, you're feeling at home in Croatia?
Yes. Well, yeah. Everything that I see in the people that were strongest in my family is played out in how these people
are. Yeah, yeah.
This is a little bit different this year, so you know, I'm just thinking back to how we've done it before, but we've been coming here now, this is our ninth year here, and if you notice, the tour bus had a hard time getting here, and the reason is, this is not a touristic place.
The village clearly offers something that gracious great cities cannot, and that is a connection with one's ancestors. Here the rural atmosphere still retains traces of what they experienced and how they lived. It was certainly a hard life, but there was community in work and play, and a shared history that many of these families living in Bukovlje can trace back more than 200 years. Imagine that continuity. And now Robert and Sue have become a part of the village's cultural identity, for they have been coming now every year except 2020, and this year we are celebrating the 10th anniversary of that first visit as a new village tradition commemorated each time with cake.
So this is our third anniversary,
Bravo!
While there is a fair amount of eating and drinking, singing and dancing, for those who wish it, there is always a mass in the village church, or there is an option to go for a village walk to the site of an old settlement perched above the river. Here too one can find the remains of the oldest church ever excavated in the continental part of the country. Dating from the 5th century, for the past 10 or so years, archaeologists from Croatia and Austria have been uncovering the various structures and part of the perimeter wall of this ancient and complex site. Seventh year now in Bukovlje,
yes.
Digging in Gradišće. Where are the main areas that you've been focusing on this year?
So since we are planning to conserve the church in 2 years, the first goal was to excavate around the apse, on the outer side of the apse, so that we can conserve it next year. And we were very interested in finding the towers. We assumed there are four for sure towers, maybe five. And this is why we opened this area that we assume there is a one tower, and we excavated it. It's semicircular. It has a radius 3.3 meters. And it's built on the outer side of this defensing wall of the fortress, and the wall is really astonishing.
The walk also provides an opportunity for more relaxed conversation. In each of these visits, I try and listen to the stories of people tracing their ancestral roots, and I managed to record a number of them, but none of them were as profound as this story.
Okay, my name is Paulette Johnson. I hesitate because I feel like my name is now Paula Rupcic, but I didn't know that when I started this. And when I first, I came to Croatia because I never knew my Croatian background, and I've been looking for 20 years. And all I knew was that my grandfather was named Joseph Rubik, and he was from Croatia. And that's all I knew a month ago. So I made up this flyer. I don't know if you can see it. Mm-hmm. I started writing a blog about trying to find my grandfather and my Croatian relatives, and I said in it, I can't find them, they're going to have to find me. And that's kind of what happened when I came here. So basically, when I came here, I just Googled Rupcic, and I made a hotel reservation at any place that had Rupcic in the title. And so the first place was near Plitvice Lakes, but the second place was in Zadar. And by then, Robert Jerin had told me, you know, you should be looking around Zadar. So I got an email from some strange woman saying, I was looking on Ancestry and I saw that you're looking for Joseph Rubik and you should look in Zadar. And I wrote her back and I said, well, that's funny because I'm staying there with Ivan Rupcic. She goes, well, that's odd because that's my brother-in-law. So we get to Zadar and I get an email from a Croatian genealogist saying, I think I know where your grandfather's from. I think he might be from Zadar, and this is his birthday. So I had this one picture of him. So we came and we're staying with Ivan Rupcic, who happens to be Hare Krishna, which was, what am I doing here in this village? And he takes us up to Kal, the small village where they think this Joseph Rupcic is from. And we're looking around and we look at the village and we leave, and we happen to see a thing on the wall that says the partisan World War II losses. And they listed Nikola Rupcic, same father as the Joseph Rupcic she found, Rupcic. Hmm. So Ivan knew everybody in town, and so he hooked me up with these two women who are from that lineage. And I was showing my picture and I was saying, this is a picture of my grandfather who came to America 100 years ago. And they said, you know, 60 years ago I saw a picture like that, but he was sitting down. And then they were arguing with each other in Croatian, and maybe, maybe not, maybe not. Meanwhile, we go to the records office and they have the birth records of Joseph Rupcic and my grandmother. So then Ivan takes us to this man in town who is a 96-year-old genealogist, and he has the family history of everybody in the entire Novi Vinodolski. And it laid out everybody, and it said Joseph Rupcic, it stops. So that means he went to America. So the two cousins invited me over. I walk in the house and they said, we have to show you something. And I go over to the table, and there on the table is a picture of my, there, they found the picture of my grandfather that had been sent them 60 years ago. And they turned it over and it said, in memory of Joseph Rubik, who went to America.
Wow.
And that's, you know, my brother died, my father died, and I just felt, what I said is I wanted to feel I wanted to feel my heart in the on the ground. Mm. I wanted to feel my heart in the ground of the homeland. And that's kind of what happened.
Fantastic.
You know, it was so... It, every day, something happened that was a miracle. And like we told Yvonne, we'd like to hear Klapa music, and so he set up a private Klapa music concert. And one of the players said, you know, that town you're from, people are trying to preserve the culture. And it's just like this. It's a little town, wonderful people, everything. So we get an invitation to a barbecue up there, and it turns out that it's my cousin, and he lives next door, to, and he shows us the house where my grandfather was born. And they're showing me the dances and the songs from 200-300 years ago, just by chance.
Yeah.
You know?
Mm-hmm. So what does it mean for you to come to a vintage like this?
It's like going home, you know, and I can't understand it. It's, you know, I'm trying to think, what is it that you connect to so much, that moves you so much, you know? I'm thinking at home, you have your grandma, and that's about it. And that's about as far as you go back. Mm. But when you come here, there's something so, it's like my family and my people have always existed. Mm. I just didn't know where they were. You know, I didn't know where they were, and they've been here waiting for me all
this
time.
They found them, yeah. Well, they found you.
I said, they found me.
Yeah.
You know, so when we just left Yvonne's house yesterday, and he was always doling out little pieces of the story for us. You know, he wouldn't
piece by piece.
He would. He said, "You must wait. You have to be patient. You must wait." And like a week into staying there, he says, oh, right across the street here, that's where your grandfather went to church. So we were leaving yesterday, and he says, I have a gift for you. I have something for you. And he raises cows. Mm-hmm. So he gives me a machete, and he says, come with me. And I'm like, what is he going to do? And he takes a straw bale, and he cuts it in a piece off of it, and he gives me the string, and then he gives me a key to the house. Now I have a key to the house. And I don't want to leave.
Yeah.
Over these years, Bukovlje has tried to show our many guests the wonderful potential waiting to be discovered in the village, where handicrafts are exhibited and young talent is nurtured. These visits have been such a joy to the village, and the connections and friendships made are special. Sadly, over the years we have lost friends, and even one member of the women's group. But even if these friendships only last for a day, the memory still lingers. So, Robert and Sue, today we celebrate your 10th anniversary, in the hope that there will be many more opportunities in the future, where we can make friends and join hands across the ocean and find common ground and speak a common language. I shall give one of our first guests the last word.
What does it mean for you to come to a village like this and experience this kind of...
Beer!
It's like coming home.
You feel that? Yeah. Oh,
these people... These people, they're sharing from their heart.
Yeah.